Hello everyone, today I have something interesting for you. I continue to analyze the multiverse called Skibidi Wars. We will review episode 57, 58, and 59, and then I will show you all the secrets and Easter eggs that I was able to find. Is it true that Tri-Titan is about to join the Skibidi Toilet side? Will G-Man be able to come back from the final battle, and how badly hurt is he? Did Tri-Titan really teleport to this multiverse to get revenge on G-Man? Get your tea and snacks ready and watch this video to the end. It'll be the best thing you've seen today. Let's go. We finally get to the episodes with the epic battles between Titan and G-Man. I've previously said that the main feature of this series is the endless Titan battles with surprising kinds of Skibidi toilets, and now I can show you that. So episode 57 is here, and we are immediately introduced to a lovely lady. We saw her in the early 14th episode of the original series. But she uses a sink instead of a toilet, and it has a special protection. The Skibidi woman has a small antenna on her head and a special weapon with a red glow on it. These weapons are frequently used by Skibidi toilets in this multiverse. She also has an iron tentacle that she uses to grab the poor cameraman. I don't know what she wants to do with him, but I don't think her goal is to destroy this buddy. Maybe she's gotten too bored with destroying cameramen and wants to have a little fun with him, who knows? This Love Priestess plans unfortunately are disrupted by a Tri-Titan, and this big boy lands just right on top of her. She has no choice but to release the hostage. This poor lady was so scared that she even gave his head a nice pat. She's like, "Hey, Blood, he's fine, can I just leave, please?" Skibidi Woman is so scared that she even loses her defense on the sink. But it's not that simple, and Tri-Titan turns Skibidi Woman into a damn grilled chicken. Unfortunately, we don't see the cameraman after that. And it seems that this poor guy fell at his own savior's hands. We saw a similar place in episode 55. Here we have the same anti-parasite cannon on this Jeep and a speaker man who was cured from the parasite. A Titan speaker man fell near this tunnel in the end of episode 55, but he's not here in this episode anymore. This guy is probably in the lab right now and we'll definitely see an improved version of him in time. After that, Tri-Titan gets hit by a projectile, and it was done by the sink cannons from episode 56. It's weird that Tri-Titan fought them, because in episode 56, the same cannon fired a sink parasite capsule and infected TV Man. Why the hell didn't that happen to Tri-Titan? Look at that explosion. It's really nothing. I can't believe such a huge cannon fires just regular rockets and not even a parasite capsules like in last episodes. Anyway, Tri-Titan has no trouble dealing with those sinks just by blowing them off and the episode ends. I think this weapon only works against regular Alliance members. I said earlier that Tri-Titan is an alien that the Alliance has switched to their side. Maybe that's why parasites don't work against him? Or maybe it's a different type of cannon. But then I don't understand why we've been shown how a sink cannon works before. The next episode immediately begins with an epic chase. This time, the events take place in the desert, where two cameramen are running away from G-Man. Along the way, they knock over a few toilets, and among them we can spot a Skibidi octopus. We saw him in episode 51 of this multiverse. The cameramen pass right under him, and G-Man seems to be right there. I can't explain why he couldn't hit the car in front of him and destroy the Skibidi toilet with his first shot. It's so dumb, isn't it? The car that these speed racers take a leap of faith with is from the Half-Life 2 game. And damn it, after that stunt, episode 58 deserves to be released alongside Fast and Furious 10. On the way, the cameramen meet a familiar vacuum toilet from the 46th episode of the original series. After that, we leave the car and G-Man is getting ready to finish this race. He has special armor and two lasers, just like G-Man from the original series looked in episode 38 after the first upgrades. We look at our Uber driver and prepare to go to the other side of the world. But Tri-Titan comes to our rescue again. He delivers a powerful heel kick and shows G-Man his place. But it's not that simple, and even after such a powerful explosion, G-Man realizes and strikes the Titan back. Looks like it's time to use the cameras and show who's the big daddy here. It's strange, but the Tri-Titan didn't lower the cameras to shoot as he did in episode 54, but decided to bend down. It's really goofy and reminded me of the last analysis where in episode 5 of the Skibidi multiverse the freak didn't use his hands and just pulled his head towards the camera toilet. Also, G-Man's jetpack looks a lot like Cinema Man's inverted turbine from episode 45. After the camera shots, we are crushed by a vacuum toilet and the episode ends. Where the hell did that toilet come from? At the beginning of the episode when the car stopped, this guy was behind us. and there's no way he could have gotten around them without being seen by us. And there are two possibilities. Either it's a different vacuum toilet or this weirdo can teleport. I don't know. And so episode 59 is now on your screens, and we see a continuation of the battle from last episode. Here we see the bastard who destroyed the POV and the water cistern is also standing here. And if we go back to the last episode, this cistern was in the same place, which means that right now, this bastard is running over the cameraman from the last episode and the action is happening at the same time. Anyway, G-Man attacks the Titan and you can tell by the explosion that this shot really did a lot of damage to him. The Tri-Titan seems so confident in his powers that he didn't even put on a jetpack in the first few seconds. After the shot, G-Man flies away, but Tri-Titan seems to be able to teleport and play baseball with the bastard himself. It's weird why G-Man didn't turn around, because right now he's looking at the Titan and should be able to see him teleporting. Poor bastard didn't expect this twist to happen. This guy is really blind or dumb if he couldn't see the teleportation. That's why he also couldn't hit the car at point-blank range and shot at the friendly Skibidi toilet. If there's an eye doctor in this multiverse, he should visit him and get special glasses for his eyesight. But let's get back to the episode. Tri-Titan grabs the creep and forces him to kiss the ground. Explosion was so powerful, and I think it's definitely over this time. Tri-Titan shows off all his power, and in this time some snot decides to shoot him with his little thingy. Just look at that little lame. Compared to Titan, this guy looks really funny, and I don't know what he was expecting of this attack. I wonder why the Skibidi toilet has another rocket after the shot. I don't see where he keeps his supplies, and his cannon is only built for one rocket. It's really weird. This bug is destroyed, but G-Man survived somehow again and tried to fire his lasers. His toilet looks unusual and seems to be made of stone or something. Maybe that's why G was able to take so many hits? Tri-Titan got tired of this and delivered the most powerful attack of all. He used his TV at the same time as the camera guns and fed G-Man with radiation enough. Dude, why'd you have to put them down this time? Did you just want to stretch your back a little last time or what? If G-Man lives through this again, I'm tearing my hair out. We're watching this shot from another cameraman's view, because it looks like the explosion of such force destroyed the past POV. And once again, the Tri-Titan obliterates the cameraman just in case. This Titan doesn't seem to care about them, and that scares me a bit. This guy is as mysterious as the TV men in the original series, and I'm afraid to trust him. There is also a theory that Tri-Titan is really an alien, and his planet was destroyed by G-Man, and then Jimmy went to this planet to take over. But Tri-Titan decided to get revenge on him, and so he sided with the Alliance, who gave him improvements of all three Titans. But what if the parasite capsule really worked, and Tri-Titan is about to be infected? If you don't understand what capsule I'm talking about, I highly recommend watching the last analysis where I explained it in detail. But what about G-Man? Is he really destroyed this time? Most likely he will come back improved in the next episodes, and the battles will be even more epic, and I will show you that very soon. Write in the comments your theories about Tri-Titan. I'll be very interested to read it. And that was me. ISO Toilet, see ya!